like it's literally been a month since I released the Marlin 5 for 2021 video, but the Marlin 5s for 2022 have already been released. So let's go check them out. So the Trek Marlin 5s, I feel like I literally just did the comparison video of the Trek Marlin 5s to 2021, but here we are 2022, well, we're still in 2021, but the 2022 Trek Marlin 5s have gone live on Trek's website. They are shipping in very shortly. We have a bunch on order, tons are already pre-spoken for. Like, it's a crazy year. The bike shortage is 100% real, and the bike companies are handling it. Alright, so let's talk about the big changes, because there is some big changes here, and they're bigger than probably the past 2 years of Trek Marlins, maybe even 3 years in the Trek Marlin 5. Okay, so the Trek Marlin 5s have finally changed drastically throughout the entire series, and I think this time they'll actually ship with the part spec that they were supposed to 2 years ago. Big change this time is they're upping to the 2x8 system, the same as what's on the current Trek Marlin 6. So that means you're gonna get a much faster shifting experience. It's much cleaner and it's gonna be better for trail riding, which is excellent. And it's actually gonna just be an overall better power spec for such an entry level bike. Now the price has gone up on top of the price has already gone up, but this time it's actually worthwhile. It's not just a random price increase due to manufacturing, blah, blah, blah. This is actually a power spec upgrade. And you're pretty much getting all upgraded everything so close to a Marlin 6 that you could call it a Marlin 6, but it's now cheaper than the Marlin 6. So it'll be interesting when they release the actual Marlin 6, how it kind of pairs out and becomes something. But until then, Trek has released a pretty good product. So the shifting 2x8, it's gonna be way faster than the previous one, getting rid of that tawny stuff. As well, they go into a lockout from fork, pretty much the exact same that's on the Marlin 6 currently for the 21 model year, but assumably that's gonna get replaced very shortly here. Everything else is pretty much the same. So the wheel size is staying the same, except they have introduced a brand new model, extra extra small, with a 26 inch wheel. So now it starts 26 inch wheels for the extra small. Extra small and small are 27 and a half, and then the medium and larger are all going to the 29. So it's that smart wheel size that Trek calls it, but in kind of a better, simpler format. Part spec wise, very similar to the Marlin 6. Has all the mount points, which is kind of nice. So that same rear rack kickstand integrated mount, which is really nice, cleans it up a lot instead of getting one of those kind of clamp on style. The brakes are going to be really good hydraulic disc brakes. I mean, really good for the level of bike it is. Really good, honestly. Obviously, there's better out there, but Trek's really done a good job this year, and I think increasing the price a little bit more than it already has, but increasing the part spec to be as good as another model, which is more expensive, shows they're trying to be really aggressive in this market, shows like building the brand, growing a little better. It'll be interesting when they release the Marlin 4 and the Marlin 6 to see where they play out, as if they've shifted the whole series, especially with that Trek Marlin 8 out now. It's really like it's becoming more of a premium model, premium bike, which is really nice to see. So who's this bike for? Realistically, it's for the same person the Trek Marlin 5 was before, but now with the price spec of the Trek Marlin 6, essentially, it just makes it a better overall bike. I honestly don't think the 3x is really needed in any way, unless you're really a strict commuter and then go to a dual sport or something like that anyway. But even those ones are kind of losing some of that 3x on it. It's just not needed. You can fit more gears in the back now, whether it's going all the way to an 11 speed in the dual sport or 8 now in the back of the Marlins. It's really just not needed. So it's nice to see it simplify a little bit more. It makes it easier shifting. Honestly, even people who are getting into the sport, it's kind of overwhelming for them. All these gears, they may not know what to do with it. So it's nice to just simplify it. 2 on the front, 8 on the back. You've got every choice you need, but it's going to work really well. Having that lockout front fork as well is going to be nice, but the big benefit is just the upgraded fork. So it's actually going to be a better performing suspension than previous years. Anyone who has a current Marlin 5, it might be a worthwhile upgrade. With all these upgrades, obviously, I haven't got one in yet. This is what Trek is now officially reporting on their public website. Hopefully this is what ships in. Obviously with the part shortage, it might even make more sense for them to simplify all the models to be more similar part spec. might be easier on the Shimano kind of manufacturing side. Does sound like Trek has the most amount of orders from Shimano. So yeah, it's going to be exciting to see these bikes come in the next few weeks to a month here. We'll post a video about that when we actually get them in. I have thrown up some pictures straight off the website to show you what they look like. They look pretty similar to the Marlin 5, so some really good colors to them, but with the power spec of essentially a Marlin 6. So it's gonna be interesting to see how they pan out, how they actually ship. Obviously, over the past couple of years, they say one thing and then sometimes something else ships in and they change their decision afterwards. It's all down to manufacturing. Right now, there's a part shortage, and definitely it's probably easier to just ship out one singular style of part for Shimano's sake, and then put that on the bike, and all the bike industry kind of fit to that. Makes the most amount of sense to me, but I don't know. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching this quick video. I dropped my phone and broke it a couple times here. So I got some masking tape over it. I don't know what to do yet. I don't really want to buy a new phone. I don't know how long it can last without the glass back here and just some tape over it. But it'll be interesting. It'll be interesting. Anyway, let me know, what phone should I look into? Are you gonna order already? Do you have a 2022 on order or even riding one already? Is anyone out there already riding it? Let me know in the comments below. My name's Chris, and you have to click to subscribe to see the developments of videos. It's gonna get better on here, trust me. It's just gonna get better. We're gonna just keep watching.